This is basically everything you need to change your oil on a Honda 919. I'm changing the filter too, of course, but I've got some GN4 10W40 Honda motorcycle oil. You can get this from Jeff Bezos. I got this from Jeff Bezos too. This is a KN204-1, and this one is nice. You could get the Honda one, but this one is nice because it has the hex socket on the top so that you can easily remove it. And you remove that with a 17 millimeter wrench, and you remove the drain plug with a 17 millimeter socket. I also have a oil catch pan.
It's hard to fit this sort of full size car oil pan underneath the bike. I had to lift the bike up and it's just resting on the exhaust, but it's fine, it'll work. So I've already loosened the drain bolt here. And there is no one but me to blame for anything that goes wrong with this oil change, because I was the last one to change the oil on this bike. So I'm gonna do the good trick where I get it to the last few threads and then push up. So I did this on the Cadillac oil change, so I'm pushing up. The oil can come out right now, and I'm gonna very quickly remove it now that we're on the last threads. 3, 2, 1, there we go. There's the drain plug. There goes the oil. Looks really, really dark.
All right, it's dripping out the last bit of oil. I did forget to mention that you should warm up the bike just so the oil flows out of the engine a little bit better. I also forgot to mention that I opened the oil fill cap here just so that the oil will flow out better. I've also rigged up this funnel, so the oil fill hole is really small, so I'm having to use this stupid extension thing. When we refill the oil later, we'll tilt the bike straight and we can see the oil level here, but we'll see that in a minute. Next up is to remove the oil filter. So I have a controversial opinion on this part of the oil change. A lot of people will put foil all on the headers and try to get the oil to flow out. I feel like that makes more of a mess than anything, so I'm just gonna remove it and then just clean off the headers when I'm done. Like, I don't understand why that's such a big deal to just wipe off the headers. All right, I'm gonna ratchet this on nice and tight so that I don't forget about it now. All right, here we go, ready? Click. Yeah, that's fine. I really feel like every oil filter should have this hex attachment on the end. That makes it so easy. Oil filters are always a pain. Whatever. Easy. Yeah, the headers cool down pretty quickly, so even if you warm up your bike beforehand, it doesn't stay very hot. Out with the old and with the new. Okay, so on the new filter, I poured a little bit of oil in the hole to prime it, and I put a little bit of oil on the O-ring. So do note that there is an O-ring, so you want to have an O-ring on the new one, and you want the O-ring from the old one to not be there. So I wipe this down so it's nice and clean. I'm gonna throw the new filter on. Just like this. So it should thread on very easy. You see how it just spins like that? Easy. That's how you know you aren't cross-threading it. If the 919 is your first motorcycle or your first oil change on your motorcycle, this is an easy one to learn on. Got the 17 mil wrench. Just gonna tighten it. Not gonna tighten it too much, just like, you know, I can tighten it all the way with just my thumb and the wrench. What I'll do is I'll run the bike and I'll check it to make sure it's not leaking oil. All right, so here's the ratchet set up so that I can hold the camera in one hand and pour with the other. I'm just gonna slowly pour this in. So I'm just gonna put in maybe 3 quarts. The engine should take a little less than 4 quarts, but usually the rated oil capacity is a little bit more than what you end up having to add, because there's always just a little bit of oil left in the engine, even if you let it drain for a long time. So before you put the new oil in, just make sure your drain plug is tight, make sure your oil filter is tight, and put the new oil in. And it's better to add too little than too much. Start with a little bit and then put in more later. That's about 3 quarts. We'll let it settle and then we'll check the oil level here. All right, so when I tilt the bike up straight, you can see the oil level is a tiny bit low. Hope you can see that. So I'm gonna add just a little bit and we should be good. I cleaned up everything while the oil was settling, and you can see I cleaned up the headers. They look fine. You know, maybe if you have a show bike, you need to worry about getting oil on the headers, but I think this is fine. Everything's on, buttoned up. Just gonna put a tiny bit more oil in, put the cap on, and start her up. All right, there she is. She's running good, no leaks. That's how you change your oil on a Honda 919. Keep it easy.